We've had this kind of constant moving of the goalposts by the red shirts. First of all, there was talk about them bringing Bangkok to a standstill when the verdict came in on seizing $1 billion of Thaksin's assets. That never happened. They then postponed the demonstration to Saturday. They didn't get that many people then. They then moved to Sunday. Everyone was wondering if something was going to happen yesterday. Now they've issued this ultimatum that if the government doesn't leave by midday today, they will increase pressure. They're talking about surrounding the army compound where the prime minister is in a safe house. But frankly, I mean, there were, I was down there yesterday, there were about 80,000 protesters gathered in the center of Bangkok, but not the million people that they had threatened at one point. So at the moment, it appears that the Reds just simply haven't got the numbers to bring down this government.
And Dan, what has been the reaction from the government and the Prime Minister?
Well, he has consistently said it is their constitutional right to protest, that they won't stop them doing that, but there is talk of them invoking a state of emergency if things get out of hand. Already they've implemented what's called the Internal Security Act, which puts soldiers in charge of trying to restore law and order. That would be kind of stepped up by a state of emergency, which would, you know, effectively they could impose curfews and ban large gatherings of people. At the moment, though, the government seems to be trying to sort of wait and watch to see if this thing will peter out. Will people lose interest after several days of threats and no real follow-through, or will they manage to get more and more people beginning to gather in the center of Bangkok? So I think the next sort of 24 hours are pretty critical for the red shirts. If they can't get more people to turn out, then the worry is, I suppose, that a small, hardcore faction will try and stir up trouble as they did last April. But certainly I don't think they have the numbers to say that they can bring down this government through sheer weight of numbers and protesters.
Dan, finally, any word from the man that these red shirt protesters support, Thaksin Shinawat?
Well, he's been issuing various text messages and tweets. He rang into one of the demonstrations over the weekend, urging more and more people to turn out. He is very much pulling the strings of this movement, albeit from a destination a long way away. There are reports that he's been kicked out of Dubai for breaching his promise not to use Dubai as a political base to continue his campaign. So there is now speculation that he has moved somewhere else, possibly to Europe or possibly to neighboring Cambodia. But certainly he is intimately involved with the funding of this red shirt rally. We've seen pictures emerge over the weekend of red shirt protesters being given about $70 US to turn out. And that money, it's thought, is coming from Thaksin's considerable coffers that he still has, billions of dollars, it's thought, hidden offshore that he's using to fund this red shirt movement.